Good afternoon. I'm John Cullen, and I'm president of the American Academy of Family Physicians. I'm a family physician, and I deliver babies. And since I'm a family physician, I take care of families, and my greatest joy as a physician is watching the kids that I deliver grow up to be adults. And we do this in the most isolated community in the country. This is Valdez, Alaska, population 4,000. We're 300 miles from the nearest hospital. And it is a beautiful place. There are snow-covered mountains and glaciers that just drop right into the ocean. But we also have some of the worst weather on the planet. I mean, it is Alaska. And we can be weathered in for days at a time. And yet, our healthcare team and I could take care of pregnant women and newborn children, and we do it safely and compassionately. And if we can deliver babies safely and compassionately in Valdez, Alaska, no one else has any excuse. So I had a young woman come into our hospital in labor at 31 weeks with twins. And there was a driving snowstorm, and there was no chance of getting her to Anchorage that day. And all we had in town was three family physicians, a medical student, and our extremely competent nursing staff. But we took care of them, because as a community, we made the decision that we were going to be offering pregnancy care, delivery care, and care for raising children to make that as safe as possible. So as I said, I'm also president of the American Academy of Family Physicians, and I represent more than 134,000 family physicians, residents, and students. And we are committed to making pregnancy, childbirth, and raising a family as safe as possible across this country. My dad told me years ago the most important purpose of society is to take care of pregnant women and children. So what does that say about our great country when it is now more dangerous to have a child than it was the day that he told me that? If you're rural, your risk is much higher. And if you are a minority, your risk is much higher. And if you are a minority living in a rural community, your risk is multiplied. There are counties in this country where the infant mortality rate is over 40 per thousand. That's 1 in 25. That is unconscionable. And much of this disparity has to do with access. We've lost over 100 rural hospitals in the last 10 years, 22 just in the last year. And there is 200 more hospitals in danger of closing. And others have closed their obstetrical units. And this has created obstetric deserts where there are no services available for hundreds of miles. And when this rural safety net fails, moms and babies die. We cannot allow this to happen. And there is a bias and an institutional racism that contributes to this. Most of these closures are happening in rural communities with largely minority populations. And this must be fixed. Women who have to travel more than a couple of hours for prenatal care or to deliver are more likely to have complications, they're more likely to have premature deliveries, or to deliver in some place that's inappropriate, like the side of the road. Your risk of dying in pregnancy or having a healthy baby should not depend on your zip code. And it's more than just deliveries, because we know that complications from pregnancy start from the very beginning of pregnancy and last for a year after the baby is delivered. And the scariest case that I remember after 25 years in practice was a woman that had a 12-week miscarriage. And she almost bled to death just going from the ER to the OR. And thank God that my medical team and I could handle miscarriages and that we knew how to do a DNC, because otherwise we and her family would have lost her. And there are procedures that need to be available throughout the country. And I've seen the ravages of postpartum depression, flare-ups of autoimmune disorders and postpartum infections. These all occur in the communities that new mothers live. where now for many there are no services for 100 miles. And then the other issue is that the insurance only lasts for Medicaid for most people up to 2 months after the delivery. The American Academy of Family Physicians believe that health is a fundamental, basic human right. So we in Valdez, Alaska, we knew that even if our policy was that we were not going to deliver babies, we knew we were still going to deliver babies. We just wouldn't be able to handle the complications. And so we worked to build that medical team to deliver safely. And the result has not only been healthier babies, but a healthy community. The nurse standing by my side in a difficult delivery or a C-section is the same nurse that's standing by my side in a major trauma or illness. Providing obstetrical care means better outcomes. Having young families means healthy schools and a vibrant community. And the greatest gift given to me as a physician, like I said, is to watch these kids grow up and to be adults. I know that this is possible.